If you're selling on eBay and you're not implementing these three easy strategies, you're just leaving profits on the floor. And I know that even the most professional sellers are not implementing this or not doing that right. Short intro and we are starting. Hello everybody! So, I'm recording this video after a call with one of our big sellers on AutoDS, a seller with over 2,000 listings on his eBay stores. This seller didn't know about these strategies and I checked it with some other sellers and they also didn't implement all these three strategies or part of them. So I decided to record this video because it's critical and these steps are so easy to implement that it's a waste of profits if you don't do that. So let's begin. Step number one, there is something on eBay which called a best offer. Best offer is something where you can give to your buyers an option to offer their best price for your product and then after they offer it, you can decline the offer or approve. Now, you can do that automatically. You can just apply a rule to your listings, on your listings, where if the buyer puts an offer which is higher than the limit that you offer, it will be automatically declined or approved. So let's see how to implement it. So I go to my eBay store, I click on selling, then I click on listings, and here what I will do is I will click on near the actions, I will choose all my listings, click on sell it faster, and click add best offer. It will show me all of the listings that are eligible for a best offer option. Mostly it will be all of your listings. Now I will click here automatically accept offers at least percentage off. So I will put here 5 and automatically decline if it's less than 5. Now what does it mean? As dropshippers we always know what our profit margins. For example, for me, I know that all of my listings will start from 10% in profits for any of my listings, and that's what I will put here. I will put here 5%. Now, I will click add best offer, and it will put the best offer for all of my listings. Now, if the buyer will offer a price which is better than 5% off, for example, if they will put 4% a discount for their best offer, it will be approved automatically. If it will be less than 4%, for example, if the buyer will put 10% discount, the offer will be declined automatically. Now, there is a bug on eBay that it will write there was a problem adding best offer. It's fine, don't worry, the offer was still applied. How to test it? Just open any of your listings and you will see here the best offer option and the make offer button. If you see that, it means that the offer was applied automatically and now any of your buyers will be able to put their best offer here. Tip number two. This one may sound very basic for you, but a lot of sellers are not doing that and there is one requirement for this one. And the requirement is that you will have enough limits in your store. If you don't have, just call eBay and ask for more limits. It's even better to put more listings with higher quantity than one than put more listings with quantity one. When it's relevant if your store limits are not used and you can still list more products in your eBay store because each quantity of each product will count as another listing. So let's see what does it mean. I recommend you always to work with quantity more than one in your listings if you have eBay limits. How to implement it in AutoDS? Let's start from that and after that I will show you the strategy number 3 which will use the quantity of your listings to upsell for your buyers and sell for them more than one listing, more than one quantity of any of your listings. So let's see how it works. I will go to AutoDS, I will click on the monitors page. Then I will go to the relevant supplier settings, in my case it's Amazon settings. I will edit it and here under the quantity to raise to, I will put in my case for example 5, you can even put 2, 3 or any other number that you want and I will click apply. The next step here will be to go to the orders monitor and change the quantity to raise 2 also to 5, because after the product sold I will always want to put it back to the same quantity that it was before. Now what I will do is that I will implement another strategy, and this is the strategy number 3, to sell more from this quantity of my products. So the first strategy was to give our buyers the option to put the best offer for our listings. The second one was to give them the opportunity to buy more than one from each of our products. And this one is critical, because I see in my stores a lot of buyers who buy, even without this third strategy, more than one of my products. You can always see in your orders page after you implement it how many buyers will go to your listings and buy 2, 3, 5 quantity of your products, especially now when the holidays are coming and people will buy gifts to the people that they want to give them gifts, and maybe they will buy more than one from more than one person. So let's see how we can implement the strategy number 3 and give our buyers the willing to buy more than one of our products. So what we will do is that we will give them a discount for buying more than one. Let's see how to do that. I will go to manage active listings, and then I will click here on the marketing. I will go to promotions. At the top I will click on create promotion and volume pricing. Volume pricing means that if someone will buy more than one of our listings, of our products, they will be able to get a discount. So let's see how it works. Offer name, it's just volume pricing. And here, for one, we will not give them a discount for sure. For two, we will give them 5% discount. Basically, that's what eBay recommends. So if eBay recommends us to give 5% discount, it means that usually this is what works the best on our buyers. Then for 3, we will put here 6%, and for 4, we will put 8% discount, for example. Now, something important here, you need to calculate that it's still profitable for you after the break-even and all of the expenses, because remember, the profits that you put on AutoDS are after the break-even and after all of the expenses. So it means that 5% from the final price will not be 5% profit that you put on AutoDS. So make the calculation and make sure that you are not losing money. By the way, this is super relevant also for the first technique that I showed you in this video. Now, after that, what we will do is that we will just put here on the date range to start now and to finish on, it doesn't matter when. So I will just put a month from now, or even 2 months from now. Then what you will do here is to click on launch. It will ask you to add inventory, so click add inventory. Click on create rules. All inventory here, price up to unlimited price, I will just put here the maximum, from 0 to the maximum, and I will click here on save and review. The next step will be to click launch, and boom, our promotion is ready and running. I'm going now to the selling again, because I want to test out that this rule really worked well. So I will go to listings, I will open any of my listings, for example this one, and what I can see here is that we can see here the volume pricing. Now, something very important, don't forget that you need a quantity that is over than one, more than one, because otherwise the volume pricing will not be visible for your buyers, because they will not be able to buy more than one quantity of your products. These strategies are strategies that I really recommend to everyone to implement in their stores, because they will increase your sales a lot, and you will see that. Also, it works perfect with the monitoring when you put the pricing with a discount by percent and not by dollars, because this way, even if the price is changed on your supplier site, it will be changed on your eBay store, and the volume pricing will be also changed according to the price changing, because it's by percentage. I hope that you like this video and that you will implement this as soon as possible and you will see the results. The holidays are here and we created some super interesting articles for you that you can find below this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like this video, share it with other dropshippers or eBay sellers to help them improve their sales, and ask us anything that you want in the comment section on YouTube, and I promise you that we will go and answer any of your questions. I'm doing it every day. See you in the next videos. Bye bye.